Hey everyone, I'm Jacob from Make Science Fun. Thanks for joining me today. Now, you might have seen some of my videos with the kids playing on some of the things I've built them, and you might have seen the house in the background. Well, today I'm doing a first video on the house. It's an active, passive solar house, which I built 15 years ago. It's a pretty good house to live in. Pretty cool in summer, pretty warm in winter. It's not perfect, but it's pretty good. So come with me and we'll look at some of the features of an active passive solar house. Let's go. A hugely important aspect of any house is to have a solar hot water system. You want to convert the sun's heat into heat into the hot water. You'll probably cut 25% of your electricity bill just by having a solar hot water system. Then, if you can afford it and there's some room, you should definitely have a photovoltaic system. Obviously, a photovoltaic system changes the sunlight into electricity. This house has got 8 panels here and 8 panels up on the roof that produces a total of 2.8 kilowatts per hour. So look, on a good day, I'll probably make about 10 kilowatt hours of electricity, which is about a half of what our family needs. So it's got a pretty special roof that's like made out of like virtually surfboard foam. I kid you not. It's got a sandwich roof. Have a look up here. It's got a sandwich roof. It's got metal on the bottom, metal up the top, and it's curved. And that sandwich actually gives it strength, but it also is a really good insulation. I mean, this is what Eskies are made out of. It means that you don't lose heat during winter, and it means that you don't get heat in during summer. So, fantastic insulation on the roof. The walls of the house are made from this aerated, autoclaved concrete block. Now, it's basically full of air bubbles, like that chocolate, that bubbly air chocolate. And what all those little trapped air bubbles do is they trap the heat. So this is not only like a structural wall, but it also stops heat from going out in winter, and it stops heat from going in during summertime. So it's like a lightweight, concrete, airy block. It's cool, literally, during summer. So how does a house stay warm in winter? Well, the idea is that you need to get as much sunshine into the house as possible. So, in the southern hemisphere, so this is important, in the southern hemisphere, you want your living areas to face north. In the northern hemisphere, you want your living areas to face south. The sun rises over in the east, and in winter time has a low arc. And so during winter time, the sun goes through the glass and into the house. And in the house, you store the heat with concrete floor and brick walls. They're called thermal mass. And so the sunlight goes through the window, but then when it warms up inside, the infrared radiation can't escape because of the glass. And so it traps the heat. With glass, with curtains, with pelmets, and with insulated walls and insulated ceiling, you can actually keep inside of the house nice and warm. During summertime, you don't want the sunlight, the heat, to come into the house. But the sun is actually really high in the sky during summertime. And so you have these eaves, this is the overhanging part of the roof, that actually blocks the sun from entering the house. So in wintertime, the sun comes streaming through the window, it heats up the concrete floor, it heats up the brick wall, it heats up the sandstone structure. They're all thermal mass. So during the day they warm up, and then at night time, when the sun's gone, that's when we close the curtains, making sure that we've got pelmets. And as the house cools down slowly, well, the concrete floor, the brick tiles, the sandstone re-release that heat into the living space where you're sitting watching TV with your family and that sort of thing. And don't forget, you need to trap as much of the heat as possible. And so we trap the heat using our aerated autoclaved concrete, you know, the bubbly, foamy concrete stuff, and our nice thick insulated roof, and so the heat becomes trapped. So the entry of the house is actually like really high, and it acts like a chimney during summertime. At the end of the day, we open up those windows and cross breezes actually draw the hot air out of the house, keeping the house a little bit cool in the afternoon. Fridges use a lot of your electricity usage, about 25%. And so down here, it's hard to see, but there's actually some big vents that actually go to under the house where it's nice and cool. And as the fridge pumps heat out of the fridge, well, the hot air rises and it's replaced by cold air, which actually means that the fridge is surrounded by a cold layer, which actually makes it 20% more efficient. Amazing. So in summary, in the Southern Hemisphere, you want to have your house or your living areas facing north so that you can get the sun's light during winter time. You want to have eaves to stop the sun from coming in during summertime. You want to have good insulation on the walls, which we've used the aerated concrete block, but you can use timber frame with insulation. And you want to make sure your ceiling is insulated really well. And to keep warm during winter, you want to have lots of thermal mass inside. That thermal mass actually helps keep you cool during summer because it doesn't heat up as quickly. Active things, things like the solar panels, the hot water, the chimney which we can open up. So look, this house is really good to live in. Very warm in winter, very cool in summer. It is more difficult in the spring and autumn seasons, keeping the temperatures right, but it's just a beautiful house to live in. Over the coming weeks, we're going to be doing a series of videos on how we built the house, and so stay tuned for that. Hope you've enjoyed the video, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye for now.